Hey, what's up, y'all? Atma and Noor here.
Cacophony.
You're watching Live Raw.
Pay attention.
Life Prog, my name is Marcel Haster and I am here to bring you a brand new video review. A video review that is linked to a bit of news I recently heard. Nightwish announced that Floor Jansen is going to be their new singer, a full member of the band. Now, that news didn't surprise me because, you know, Floor was touring with the band and I knew, you know, once they know how good she is, they want to keep her. And that's exactly what I did. Now, I think Floor Jansen is the best singer in the Netherlands, definitely. It's my opinion, of course, but fortunately, I have, well, a lot of evidence to back that up. I mean, look at the history of Floor Jansen. For 12 years, she was the front woman of After Forever, one of the, probably one of the most successful Dutch, I hate that word, female-fronted metal bands. Why just not say metal bands? I mean, you know, let's leave it at that. Anyway, that is her, well, resume. But she did a lot more. I mean, she worked with Arjen Lucas and she's worked with Devin Townsend and she done a lot of things. When After Forever ended, it didn't necessarily mean the end of the musical career of all the members because everyone went and did their own thing. Floor Jansen, the same. She started a new band called Revamp. I am a huge fool that I missed out on that first album. I heard it was released, I heard amazing stories about it, but for some reason I never got to listen to it or get a copy. Now she's back with a second album, Wildcard, with a very interesting cover because you can turn it like a playing card, well, a wild card, of course, and as you can see, you have two versions of Floor. You have an evil Floor and you have a nice Floor. Now, the artwork of this album is really amazing. It's a luxurious digipack which you can fold open. And you have the band and you have Floor showing a beautiful ring. And when you take the CD out, you have Floor showing that ring again. Nice ring. And a little bit difficult to get out, we have a booklet. Now, since I am not an actor and I terrible at remembering lines, I'm going to use this as a cheat sheet and tell you a little bit more about this album and why this album particularly shows that Floor Jansen is, in my opinion, the best singer in the Netherlands. If you look at After Forever and you see what Floor did there, you know she's a very powerful singer. She has a really amazing voice, but she sang mainly in with these soprano kind of vocals. Now, of course, Floor has a lot more abilities. I mean, she studied different vocal techniques. You know, she did the Rock Academy, she did conservatory, so she did learn a lot of kind of techniques. Of course, the opera technique, but also a lot of rock singing. And on this album, show to you again, this album, Revamp, Wildcard. Floor shows that her range has expanded tremendously compared to what she did with After Forever. She really grew as a singer. On top of that, she surrounded herself with some incredible musicians because Revamp is not a Floor Jansen solo album. It is a band. And you hear that when you listen to the album because the musicians that you find on the album are really fantastic. Let me introduce to you these musicians, and here is where my cheat sheet comes in handy, because you know all these names, because they're some interesting names to be found on this album. A few of them I will introduce now, but a few others I will introduce along the way, because there are a couple of nice surprises on this album. On vocals, of course, Floor Jansen. On guitars, Arjen Reinen and Jort Otto. On bass guitar, Henk Vonk. On keyboards and synths, Ruben Weiga. And on drums, Matthias Landes. Now, to emphasize that Revamp is a band and not a Floor Jansen solo project, when you look at the writing credits, of course, Floor Jansen wrote all the lyrics. I mean, that's no surprise. She's the singer and she also does, of course, the vocal lines. But the music, the songs, were written by Floor Jansen, but also Jort Otto, Ruben Weiga, and another familiar name who also played a bit of a behind-the-scenes part on this album, former After Forever colleague Joost van den Broek. So as you can see, the musicians took place in the whole writing process, and that makes this a real band effort. And that is also what you hear, because the vocals and the music are perfectly in balance with each other. Let's just, you know, look at the album itself. I mean, I've been listening to it, and that's the reason why I call myself a fool for not having heard or even bought the first Revamp album, because when I listened to this album, I was really stunned by how great this album is and how fantastic her vocals are. The album starts out with the first two parts of a sort of a trilogy called The Anatomy of a Nervous Breakdown, On the Sideline and the Limbic System, the first two tracks. And when you listen to those tracks, wow, there you hear the range of Floor Jansen, because in those two songs, she basically goes from everything she can. You know, you have the opera, the soprano vocals in there, but you also have really beautiful, well, for lack of a better description, clean vocals. But you have powerful screams, and you also have grunts in them. And I didn't know she could grunt, but she does. And very good, I might add. So many different vocal styles are used in those two songs, and when you imagine then that that's only the first two songs, and then you have the whole album to come with a lot more of these fantastic vocals, but also musically. It is progressive metal. It is sometimes very heavy. There are really some tight riffs and there are some really vicious attacks of these rolling drums and bass, but also a lot of melody. Keyboards in his orchestration, because there are a lot of songs that have this really beautiful orchestration. Of course, the moments where Floor uses her opera voice, and you have these, you know, kind of choir sounds to back it up, which is really fantastic. But the guitar parts are really delicious, but sometimes, you know, they're a real massive attack on your ears when you come in there. So the whole band plays incredibly tight. And on top of that, you have the beautiful vocals of Floor, which makes this album a stunning album to listen to. I mean, if you love metal, you gotta listen to this album, because I'm not gonna say it doesn't get any better than this, but, well, it's getting fairly close. I mean, this is pure metal delight, absolutely. As I said, it is the balance between the vocals and the music that makes it so great. I mean, of course, you could just have Floor singing with maybe less music behind it, it would not have been as interesting as this album, you know. The whole combination works fantastic here. After those two tracks, you know, you can just sit back and, well, I wouldn't say relax, because, you know, it's a really heavy album. Fortunately, there are here and there some moments of rest. One particularly I love very much is Distorted Lullabies, which could be considered a ballad. With these beautiful orchestrations by Ruben Weiga, with these beautiful vocals by Floor, these more softer vocals, still a very powerful song. When I was listening to the album, I mean, you know, I enjoyed every bit of it. From the beginning to end of this album, I really enjoyed it. But there were a couple of tracks that stood out a little bit that I really enjoyed. And one of these tracks was the third part of this trilogy, Anatomy of a Nervous Breakdown, which is called Neurasthenia. And I was listening to that and was thinking, hey, I hear a different voice. Floor is doing a duet on that voice, so I had to check the booklet to see, because I didn't really recognize the voice. And when I was looked at it, I remembered why I didn't recognize it, because normally this guy almost screams, mainly, at least that's the recollection I have of him, because I am not too familiar with him, but Mr. Devin Townsend. He does a duet with Floor, and I gotta say, that song is really fantastic, and it really stands out when you listen to the album. It just adds a little bit more magic when Devin comes in, you know, and does a really fantastic duet with Floor. Another part that I really enjoyed was the choir. Now, when you think of choir, you think really massive, big things. But again, when I looked in the booklet, the choir here consists of three persons. Floor Jansen being one of them. Marcella Bovio from Stream of Passion also being a part of the choir. And the third one is Daniel de Jong from the Dutch metal band Textures. But still, the effect that you have when you listen to the songs and you have that choir backing up, you know, it gives the music a really grand feeling. And there are so many elements in it that makes this album stand out. I mean, you have a fantastic singer, you have a fantastic band, you have this choir backing it up.
My insecurity, my wounds, my anguish, my misery!
Don't get the standard prog metal songs. They manage to put something surprising in each song, which makes it interesting to listen to, which makes it not as predictable as you would expect, and it makes it a lot of fun to listen to the album again and again and again and then even again. So, you know, this is an album that really will keep you listening. It really captures you when you put it on, and then, well, you know, they surround you. And they really bring something really fantastic. A very good album, this is. One other song I'm going to mention, which is also one that really stood out for me, and that brings me to a little bit more background information for this album, because if you've been following Floor Jansen a little bit, and of course through the beautiful world of Facebook, we can keep in touch with, well, the whole world. But a while back, don't know exactly how long, but a while back, Floor Jansen had some serious health problems. She had a burnout, and which is, of course, not a very happy thing, especially when you are very passionate about what you do, and then you're forced not to do that. So that's must be a very tough time, and that happened after she did the first Revamp album. So she had to take about a year off, which was really hard for her. Fortunately, she got out of it very good, you know, she recovered, she's back. I mean, we have a new Revamp album. She did the Nightwish tour. She also guested it with another great Dutch band featuring her former colleague Mark Jansen, Mayan. So she's back on track, making music again and feeling better. And of course, she has a great future ahead of her with this fantastic album and the fact that she's now also part of Nightwish. So she got out of it. But on this album, she really poured in her frustration, her grief, her anger, her, well, all the feelings you have when you are going through such a period, you find on this album. And there's one song especially where you really can taste the bitterness and the frustration of that period, and that is the song Misery is No Crime. And that is probably my favorite track on this album, because of the way she sings, because of the emotions she puts in there. Again, the choir is a part of it. I mentioned Mark Jansen. He's guesting on that track, you know, former After Forever colleague, current Epica band leader, but also part of Mayan. He does the grunts and screams in that track, and you have Floor Jansen there. And when you look at the lyrics, so you see how personal the music can get. So I gotta say that is truly a very awesome track. The last track surprised me a little bit because it said bonus, you know, since that's track number 12. I don't know why it's called a bonus, because if it sounds great in the whole line of the album, it sounds great as an album ender. So, well, for me, I don't see it as, well, maybe they just had 11 tracks and they picked it from somewhere else. That is possible, I'm not sure, but I gotta say 12 tracks of absolute fantastic, often progressive, but definitely metal. So, don't be a fool like me. Don't let an album like this slip by you unnoticed. Well, unnoticed not, because hopefully you're watching this review and you notice this album. I'm forgetting something, of course. Because, you know, I'm holding it in my hand all the time. But of course you have some artwork in it, and I'm not going to show everything to you. But I kind of like this one very much. You know, these kind of cool things you have in the album as well. So, beautiful artwork, a beautiful cover. But the cover is nice, but the music is what counts. This is an incredible album. So be sure to check it out. And if you even remotely love metal, then I say this is a must-have for you. If you like metal, if you're a big fan of After Forever, if you were sad that After Forever departed like me, you know, make sure you get this album. So, well, that's my take on Wildcard by Revamp. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more video reviews. Check out lifeprog.com. Check out my Facebook page. Check out my Twitter page or my YouTube channel. You know, many ways to keep in touch with Lifeprog, because I have a lot more video reviews coming up, and I also did a lot of reviews, so check them out as well, because, well, you never know, you discover some new music. It is my goal to bring you music that is worth to be heard. This is definitely worth to be heard, and there's a lot more great music out there. So again, thanks for listening, and see you at a new video.